Despite appearances, this isn't a sad pub entertainer practicing on his home synthesizer. No, it's Giorgio Moroder, the man to blame for disco.
In Europe, the discotheque was invented before America. We did disco kind of music way before.
And then Giorgio met Donna Summer in Germany in 1975, and disco was truly born.
I did one song with Donna Summer called I Feel Love. And that song was done in a matter of a few hours because I knew so well how to do it. And it, for some other people, it may have looked very new, but for me it wasn't.
We were just enthralled with this kind of syntho pop top incredible unusual thing that Giorgio was putting out there.
Hit after hit followed, with Giorgio's throbbing trademark sound defining the era of bad taste and bad haircuts.
The first Giorgio Moroder record that I actually heard in a club and danced to was From Here to Eternity. And it was the first time I ever went to a club, and I went on my own. And I got there really early, and I just danced to the whole thing in a pair of cowboy boots, can you imagine? It was just this really hypnotic, and I think it was a forerunner of kind of like, you know, techno and kind of stuff like that.
But the disco party of the 70s didn't last.
The disco image was getting bad, and people would say, well, I did drugs, I did this, and I did disco. So the image wasn't exactly a good one, but that wasn't my fault.
Swapping his sequins and flares for, well, a sad denim shirt, Giorgio relocated to America to specialize in writing soundtracks to cinematic gems such as Flashdown. Giorgio continued to dabble in pop music, including producing singles for Blondie. But he found a new career with soundtracks for blockbuster films. It won him few fans, but at least now he's got something to work out with. And after a lifetime of disco and dodgy soundtracks, Giorgio's current project is probably his most ambitious yet. A new Italian national anthem.
The Italians in general are not really that happy with the anthem. Now the problem is how to present it to the Italians.
A word of advice, Giorgio. The anthem may need a helping hand from an old friend.
If I could say something to Giorgio and pass it on to him, I would say, ich bin jetzt in Nashville, komm doch runter und ich mach mit dir eine Platte. Hey, ich bin da, okay? Tschüss. Ich liebe dich auch.
Giorgio! I say Giorgio! Oh, never mind.
Another busload of devout pilgrims arrives at a shrine in the town of Danois, outside Paris. Who is the dead superstar? The no longer living legend who draws them to his grave in their thousands each year. Jim Morrison? Oscar Wilde? Maurice Chevalier? No, it's Claude François, singer, entertainer, and idol to a generation who bought millions of his records.
For 16 years, Claude was an idol. I mean, he let us women dream. For 16 years, he made us happy. He was our life.
And so, Eurotrash viewers, we ask you to sit back, take a deep breath, and experience the magic that was Claude François.
Dites-lui que je suis ta mère, que j'aime toujours les chansons qui parlent d'amour.
Claude François was a philosophy student who one day took off his thinking cap, put on his dancing shoes, and became a pop star at the age of 21. For 16 years, he dominated the French charts, selling more than the Beatles, until 1978, when he was mysteriously electrocuted while taking a bath. His fans were shocked, and hysterical scenes at his funeral confirmed his status as a national hero. Nicknamed Clo-Clo, he performed with some of the world's biggest stars. Here he goes, swinging with the young Jodie Foster.
Petit Clo-Clo dans mon comic strip. Viens faire des bulles, viens faire des...
Oui, des clics, quoi,
des bang, des bang, et des...
Sip, chipab.
Clo-Clo rarely wrapped his tonsils around a good tune without his backing dancers, the Claudettes. Claude loved the American show Soul Train, and the Claudettes were inspired by its funkadelic dancers. This is Prishka, one of the original Claudettes, who is now passing on Clo-Clo's dancing secrets to a new generation of female fans, dubbed the Claudinettes. Their sweatshirts read, "I love Claude." In fact, they love him so much, there's a waiting list of up to 6 months to join the class.
I tried to teach them what Claude taught me, you know. I mean, he really used to pull his hair out trying to teach me to loosen up and be more sexy. But it's funny, I find the same problem with these girls. Little sort of memories like that, they keep coming back while I'm teaching them. It's really weird that way.
But Prishka has even bigger plans to keep Clo-Clo's dream alive. Yes, who cares if the Beatles may be reforming? The original Claudettes are back. They've recorded a new album featuring their interpretation of Clo-Clo's greatest hits.
I really think that the Claudettes were an integral part of Claude François' appeal. I mean, it might sound a bit pretentious, but I believe that the public wouldn't want to see Claude without his Claudettes. I mean, we were a bit undressed, but, you know, we were very sexy.
Well, it may be like the young generation reforming without Cliff, but Eurotrash wishes good luck to the Claudettes and salutes the glittery, tight-trousered genius that was Claude François.
Our next story is about German music. When I was growing up, my parents told me that Germany was a dangerous country, that Germany should never be allowed to have guns. But today, I see that my parents were wrong. It's not guns that are the problem, it's guitars. There is nothing more scary than an MTV watching enthusiastic young German armed with a Gibson guitar, a Marshall amp and a Scorpions t-shirt. There is nothing more dangerous, my friends, that bad music.
Excuse me, Antoine, but I think there is a problem with the script. Look at that.
Problem? I don't think so, Jean-Paul.
Yes, my name is Jean-Paul and there is no Jean-Paul there. I have nothing to say to the public, you
because
know?
Because I told to you that if you yeah. wanted to be in the story about German music, you would have to wear the Lederhausen.
But I wear the Lederhausen. And you see, it's not very flattering, you know. One time I wear a kilt after the Lederhausen. You can see my legs. We always want to make my legs seen, you know. I am not a bimbo, you know. I have something else to say
Jean-Paul,
to the
Jean-Paul,
public,
Jean-Paul,
you know?
If not for your legs, what else do you really have to offer? Think about it. Okay.
Eurotrash went to Germany for a spot of musical re-education with the jolly Hamburg-based band Liedertafel Margot Honecker. Named after the wife of the former president of East Germany, the band sing the praises of ye olde communist world and its quaint customs. All its heroes, its icons, and its favorite accessories. The band are also keen on those eye-catching commie youth fashions.
We come from the tradition of the Red October and German youth singing clubs.
But before the band perform, the crowd are warmed up by the party propaganda of Dr. Kurt Euler.
Forwards, the Communist Unification Party of Germany, the KED. Glory and honour until the victory of reason. I thank you.
Yeah.
have released a number of singles which, like communism, have failed dismally. Undeterred, they've sent their latest release, Good Friends, to the real Eric Honecker, currently in hiding in Santiago. The band hopes it will cheer him up before he dies.
Hey, man!
Meanwhile, up in the mountains of Austria, they're big, they're bad, and they've got more than a million fans. These are Austria's answer to Metallica. They're called the Alpine Skirt Chasers.
Hey, man!
The Skirt Chasers are just honest blokes. Everyone chases skirt, only we admit it.
But there's more to this Lederhosen combo than just chasing the Austrian ladies.
Our music comes from the old traditions. We're just trying to, like, mix it up so the kids can dig it.
Formed 20 years ago, the band's aim is to uphold good old Austrian traditions. The band say nein to drugs and rock and roll, but preach a message of peace on earth and goodwill to the planet. With such sentiments, the Alpine Skirt Chasers have sold millions of records. This summer, they're undertaking a world tour. So if you come across them, you'll know what to say.
Hey, man!